question for me was, how was agroecology viewed by civil society? And from my perspective, I've traveled to more than 50 countries in Latin America, Asia, and sub-Saharan Africa, and talked to hundreds of policymakers, farmers, agroecologists, journalists, academics, women and youth groups. And they think agroecology is really the way to go. These are often people who don't have a lot of land, they don't have a lot of money for inputs and resources, and they've been practicing agroecology in some form or another for most of their farming careers. So they see it as the solution. They view it as a toolbox that doesn't necessarily mean that it's not low, that it's not high tech, or it can be a way for farmers to increase their incomes, but they see it as a way to continue doing what they do best and growing food, earning income for their families, and improving food and nutrition security. So I think the problem comes from some of the outside groups who tell them that these strategies aren't productive, that the science doesn't support it, when in fact it does. And these farmers have a lot of opportunities to improve their yields, make sure that hunger and poverty are a thing of the past, and that agroecological solutions can really find ways to feed local and regional communities.